Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Ambassador, in your prior testimony, you spoke so movingly about your family background. You stated that your parents fled communist and Nazi regimes and that they valued freedom and democracy offered in America, having experienced totalitarian regimes. Did that have any effect on your desire to enter into the United States Foreign Service?
Yes, it did.
Did you always know that you wanted to be in the Foreign Service? I look at your background, and it is perfectly suited for what you're doing. I note that you studied at the Pushchinsky State Russian Language Institute in Russia to learn Russian.
Yeah.
That you have do you also have an MS from the National Defense University National War College?
Yes.
I even noticed that you earned your undergraduate degree in history and Russian studies in college, and coincidentally, that was also my college. And you definitely are doing Princeton and the nation's service by what you do every day. But I really want to know how it felt to have your reputation sullied, not for state and nation, but for personal gain. You spoke about how your service is not just your own personal service, it affects your family. And today we've seen you as this former ambassador, this 33-year veteran of the Foreign Service, but I want to know about you personally and how this has affected you personally and your family.
Yeah, it's been a difficult time. I mean, I'm a private person. I don't want to put all that out there, but it's been a very, very difficult time because the president does have the right to have his own or her own ambassador in every country in the world.
But does the president have the right to actually malign people's character? I mean, it may not be against any law, but I would think that it would be against decorum and decency.
I mean, there's a question as to why the kind of campaign to get me out of Ukraine happened, because all the president has to do is say he wants a different ambassador. And in my line of work, perhaps in your line of work as well, all we have is our reputation. And so this has been a very painful period.
How has it affected your family?
I really don't want to get into that, but Okay. Thank you for asking.
Because I do care. I also want to know how you think it affected your fellow colleagues in the Foreign Service. My Republican colleagues have said that since you received such adulation from and embracing from your own fellow colleagues, that what occurred, the incident that occurred with the president and his cronies, you know, maligning your reputation, how has that had a chilling effect on the ability and the morale within the Foreign Service? Can you speak to that?
Yeah, I think that it has had exactly that, a chilling effect, not only in Embassy Kyiv, but throughout the State Department, because people don't know kind of whether their efforts to pursue our stated policy are going to be supported. And that is a dangerous place to be.
Now, for the record, my Republican colleagues will probably try to paint you as a never-Trumper. Are you a never-Trumper?
No.
As a Foreign Service officer, you took an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States without regard for who's in office. Is that correct?
Yes, that's true.
Have you also served in your 33 years for not just Democratic presidents, but also Republican presidents?
For Republican presidents.
In fact, you joined the Foreign Service under Reagan. Is that not right?
Yes, that's true.
Now, why do you think it's really important that Foreign Service officers are nonpartisan? Can you talk to us about why it's important for you to do your job and your fellow Foreign Service officers to do your job that you're nonpartisan?
Yeah. Because our work is essentially nonpartisan. And, you know, Senator Vandenberg, a Republican senator who actually partnered with President Truman, coined a phrase that politics should stop at the water's edge. And I think that's exactly right, because while obviously the competition of ideas in a democracy with different parties, different individuals, is hugely important, but at the end of the day, when we are dealing with other countries, it needs to be about what is right for the United States. Those are our national security interests. And whether an individual works for the CIA, or the military, or the State Department, we've got to be nonpartisan and thinking about what is right for the United States.
Well, on behalf of a grateful nation, well, I want to say thank you for your service, and I yield back the balance of my time.